4-10, 1-2 in the conference.
And both teams are going to have to definitely do some work today. And I like when Army comes to town against Holy Cross, because Army comes in with the presence of a lot of aggressive play, and that's just their style. And it'll be interesting to see how Holy Cross will adjust to that. Holy Cross, I think, is really more or less like a finesse player type of team. And at the same time, they really don't have a true center as well. So it should be interesting with the inside play, and that's always been playing Holy Cross over the years, is the inside position.
Army on the road this season, not doing all that well, 0-7. Holy Cross is just 1-7, but they are the lucky ones today, playing at home on the season. Holy Cross at home, not a bad record, 3-2 overall. They haven't played all that many games, just 5 of their 14 games here at the Hart Center. Holy Cross played last back on Wednesday night at Navy, and they lost that ball game 67-63. Tough loss to the midshipmen. They rallied late, but it wasn't enough. Walter Brown leading the way with 17 points, and he is the guy to look to. Only a sophomore, but he's the scorer on this Holy Cross team.
Yeah, he's their best player. He receives most of the times the ball out of the screens. You got to be able to get over the screens. And also, he's already shot it about 203 times in 3-point range. He's shot it already about 112 times. And so he can light it up at any time, and someone's definitely going to have to key on him. And you know, Holy Cross's best defensive player in the guard position is Brian Lockhart. So I'll be wondering to see if he will pick up the assignment today.
Army is playing without a couple players they had penciled in as starters this season. Alex Morris out for the year with knee problems. Christian Glow suffered a serious head injury back in practice a couple weeks ago. In fact, I think it may have been in November. He's not playing. And Alfred Forbes, who is considered a possible starter, suspended, has been suspended for a few weeks now. So Army going with a revised roster today. Still, though, their leading man, Mark Luking, the senior guard. He holds the season and career 3-point marks at Army, and he can really shoot the rock.
Scott Massessi, Walt Corbin, Dave Layton, and Mike Brigger. At guard, a 5'10 sophomore from Keystone.
We're ready for the starting lineups right now.
Jamie Updegraff.
And we'll run down the players with you. Jamie Updegraff right there, a very smart player. He'll play at the guard position. And there's Mark Luking. Great 3-point range, averaging 17-7 a game and having an offseason so far. So if he breaks out today, Holy Cross could be in trouble. Mike Rainey, the JV player, being called up to get the start today. Very emotional and athletic player. Justin Johnson starting. He'll play at forward. And the other starter is Jamie Irick. Holy Cross, we're looking at Teddy Betancourt and Brian Lockhart in the backcourt. Teddy from Peabody, Massachusetts, one of the co-captains, and he's a guy with great ability to run the offense, also solid on defense in the steals department. And Brian, of course, from Jacksonville, Florida, a good assist to turnover ratio. 1.9 assists to every one turnover this season so far for Lockhart. Pat Tutwiler in the starting lineup today. He has been in and out of the starting lineup so far this season. He's the junior forward, 6'6", from Minnesota. Chris Rojic really starting to come together as a player this season. Gets the start at forward, 6'7", 220 out of Boston. And of course, Walter Brown, the star on this team, if there is a star on this team, 6'6", sophomore out of Boston as well. Bob Fouracre broadcasting today for WWTM Radio. WWTM also did the women's game, so it's nice to see the women's game getting on the radio, and Bob, of course, an old pro at what he does.
Well, the women are definitely getting the attention. As earlier you heard in the interview, the players are getting much bigger, much taller. Hey, before you know it, I would say in years' time, you're going to be seeing a lot of the women dunking the basketball too as well.
If you were not with us for that game, Holy Cross won big, 83-29. Sophia Pena having the game of her Holy Cross career with 19 points.
Well, this is the staff at the Cadets. The Cadets go down, come in with a huge staff of assistants.
And Colgate did defeat Navy today on the women's side, 55-50. So Navy now has two conference losses. Chance for Holy Cross to be in first place without the pesky midshipmen or midshipwomen hanging around.
Well, Coach Raynan comes in this year now, is in his second season as the coach of the Crusaders, 13th coach in Holy Cross history. In his debut last year, basically finished 15-12 overall with a 9-5 Patriot League record. 15 wins are fourth most of any Holy Cross coach.
Holy Cross controlling the tip. Rojic, the first shot of the game, in and out. He gets knocked to the floor. Whistle under the hoop, more of a foul on Army. Or a violation, I think, perhaps traveling, and Holy Cross will take it back over.
Well, Chris wastes no time, and look at this guy of Walter. Walter gets up, and there's a call for a probably a possible travel there.
Denny Bettencourt behind his back to Tutwiler. Super pass, nice hoop.
Tutwiler coming out strong. He's a junior, 6'6", at 225, using his frame strong.
Down low. Luking shoots right away, but he misses his first shot. On the season, shooting 38%. Overall, for field goals, 38% from three as well.
Roger Breslin.
Good passing, and Chris Rojic gets two. Rojic leading Holy Cross with field goal shooting this season at 53%. An easy 2 points right there, and the cross is up for love.
Well, the junior forward is looking strong, and Coach Raynor's expecting big things out of Chris to play at both ends of the floor, defensively and offensively. And that time he went down the middle and was able to knock it off the glass, and then right there you can see Coach Bill Raynor.
And if I'm not mistaken, Rojic has played some guard this season. He's a big guy at 6'7", but has a nice shooting touch.
Yeah, he came out of the block slow this year, but now he's starting to come back. He's starting to feel his role on this team. He's starting. He feels real good. He's a junior. They're looking for a lot of leadership out of him, and he's been coming forth with that.
That was head coach Dino Gaudio for Army. Bettencourt from the corner, a little bit long, and out of bounds.
Uncharacteristic of Bettencourt on the baseline, not for the shot, but he kind of released it a little too quickly that time, like throwing it up by chance, and that's not usually his shot. I wouldn't suspect any more air balls after that.
Brad Paulson now in the game for Army, up to draft the shot, too strong. Rebound Cadets, no good on the rebound. Another chance, third chance, and now Bettencourt swipes it away.
Holy Cross wants to run.
Lockhart pulls it up. Tutwiler to Walter Brown. He's got a nice touch, watch out. No good there, though. Cross-court pass tipped out of bounds. Army will keep.
That's the first opportunity we got a chance to see Walter shoot from three-point land.
Graff to inbound. Jamie, a very smart player, the sophomore 5'10 guard.
As I said earlier, Holy Cross really don't have a true center. As you see, there's Roger in there. Ted Bettencourt, rather, in the guard position. Guards and forwards are on this team.
Lockhart's pass intended for Tutwiler goes right by him and out of bounds. 17:45 remaining, first turnover for Holy Cross. They do lead it 4-0.
Well, Holy Cross wants to get out of the break early. Look at the size. You got Ted Bettencourt, you got Walter, Tutwiler. You got a running team out there, and that's what they want to do.
Luking shoots it over Lockhart. No good, though. Bettencourt the rebound quickly the other way. Teddy,
that's how you take it to him. That's how you take it to him. That's what I'm talking about. He went coast to coast.
Bettencourt with two, Rojic with two, Tutwiler with two, Holy Cross up a half dozen. Army yet to score.
Nice block.
Tutwiler. Irick has his shot blocked. Holy Cross again on offense. Lockhart.
He should get that.
Working in the foul. He was mocked. And just like in the women's game, Holy Cross out to an early edge.
Look at where it all begins. It's down on the defensive board. Tutwiler with the smash off the glass. Walter gets the rebound up to Rojic. Rojic controls himself to prevent the charge, and he gets mugged right there. And Brian Lockhart locks it in, and he gets the hoorays and hurrahs from the crowd.
Couldn't get the free throw. It remains 8-0. Looked like it was Mark Luking on the foul. Armory with two team fouls. Holy Cross not yet to foul today.
Just
over 3 minutes in. Irick, strong move to the hoop, but he traveled.
Good job by Rojic, who stayed on the ground early. It didn't go for the first fake, but it went for the second. But by that time, the violation took place. Good job by Rojic preventing the baseline field goal.
And Army with four turnovers so far, having trouble on offense. Pass to Brown, tipped away, stolen. Up the graph, comes down with it, feeds to Lukic. Picks up the dribble, back to up the graph. Only crossing the man-to-man defense at this point.
Army's always coming to the heart center with a strong backcourt position.
In the corner, Lukic, boom.
Oh.
Three-pointer for Mark Lukic, it's 8-3.
Lukic bringing rain on that one for three-point land in the corner pocket. Got to watch out for Lukic, got to get a hand on him. Who got the assignment?
Lukic to match from three. He's short. Loose ball off the ground. Takes it. Running in transition. Dishes. Lukic way beyond the arc. He won't hesitate to do it either.
Does he have the green light or what?
Rebound ripped down by Rainey. Throws it into the backcourt. And that'll be a violation. Holy Cross will take over.
And hockey terms are going to be changing on the fly right here. This coach Bill Rainey, he's going to dig deep. And he's going to bring his big rebounding man, and that's Damon Hart.
Number 20, George Tatum.
He brings in a good defensive play, and also he knows how to talk the attack, the offensive glass. Holy Cross hurt once again in the post position. And this is the head coach of Army, Fran O'Hanlon. Class of 70 from Villanova.
Dino Gaudio, I think you saw the assistant say. 3-point shot for Teddy Betancourt. It's 11-3. Betancourt has five now. Damon Hart now in the game for Holy Cross as Walter Brown takes a seat. Justin Johnson back in for Army. Up the ground. Can't get it to fall. Hart the rebound. Damon leading Holy Cross in the rebounding department this season with 6.3 a game.
This is what Holy Cross wants to do. They want to get into a running offense. They want to speed up the pace.
Rebound by Tatum. He just came into the game. George Tatum still with it. Loses it from behind. Near steal by Hart, but out of bounds.
But Tatum is a threat, too. He's a freshman. Just recently started to play better. Must respect his offense. He knows how to take it coast to coast as well. And was going to try to do some damage there, but Holy Cross came up with a good defensive play.
Johnson getting it, and the lead is now 11-5.
Army playing that man-to-man pressure. Holy Cross being very patient on offense.
We've got a whistle down low. Dino Gaudio wants a foul on Holy Cross, and that's what he'll get.
This is what where Holy Cross is going to have to keep their head. This is the type of play, the type of style of play that West Point does. They're very aggressive down low. They like to bump you. Ain't nothing wrong with a little bit of bump and grind, you know. They get that going on you. And Tutwiler's going to have to keep his head. That's their style of play. Don't let them frustrate you.
Obviously, kids from Army are usually very disciplined and aggressive.
They're going to get pushed around. I'm telling you, you're going to find some people. I won't be surprised if it'd be a little pushing and shoving. A little possible fight. I'm not trying to incite anything right now, but they do play aggressive. And Holy Cross is definitely going to have to make the adjustment in their play.
John Patterson in the game wearing number 11 for Army. Tatum shot. A little bit too strong. Holy Cross will get it after the whistle. Army early on, 2 of 12 shooting, just 1 of 7. From three, and let's look at the replay. Tatum took it to the hole, but
high off the glass, and Tutwiler was in good position. Tutwiler seemed to get a little bit bigger in the frame department. This coach, Bill Rayner, instructing the offense, and he's been using his body effectively.
Nice pass inside. Hart moves on his man, two in the foul.
Hart looking strong. That was a nice pass coming down the lane. Here's the entry pass coming from Brian Lockhart. He sees a streaking Damon Hart. Does the pump, gets two.
John Kerr is now in the game, number 45 from Grafton, Massachusetts, the St. John's High School graduate. We will speak with him at halftime. Big bruiser for Holy Cross inside.
It's remarkable to even see Damon Hart in this lineup because he had a serious liver problem about a year ago. And it looked really questionable for his play this year. But he's come back strong, and he looked really good on that last outing.
Top of the key, the shot is in and out from Luking. Rebound, miss, no good. Out of bounds, Army to keep it.
Tatum is getting up there on the boards. He's getting offensive opportunities, and Holy Cross definitely have to key on that defense.
14-5, Holy Cross up by 9. You're watching college basketball on Channel 3.
American Airlines.
Hi, Mom. You look great.
Hi, honey. I feel great. Thanks to Dr. Zay.
Thank you for wearing your medical alert bracelet. You know, without it, we wouldn't have known of her heart condition.
Or her medications, right, Mom?
I always wear it. Where is my medical alert bracelet?
Don't worry. Here it is. We wouldn't let you leave without it.
If you have a medical condition or take prescription medications, medical alert could save your life. Call now for free information.
The Hart Center, Holy Cross leading Army 14-5, and they've been spreading it around. No one person in particular, Ernie. However, Ernie, Army has been cold from the field.
Okay, they've been very cold, but also you have to remember they have Mark Luking, and you don't know, but right now he's continuing to extend on Army's career scoring list this winter. Already the Patriots League third all-time leading scorer, and he stands fourth place on the Academy's career list. Just look at Ted Bencourt going the length of the court, taking an eye off the glass, and that's what Holy Cross is going to have to do, is continue to attack the offensive glass.
That was the final from earlier this afternoon. We brought it to you right here on Channel 3. Holy Cross defeating Army on the women's side, 83-29. In this game, the Cadets just 2 of 14 early on, 14%, also 6 costly turnovers. And there's the 7th one as
Justin Johnson.
Lockhart, guarded by Luking, gives to Damon Hart, moves on his man, Tatum, and draws the whistle.
It's good to see Damon Hart working on the outside. You wouldn't have seen that maybe a year or two ago. He wasn't looking offensively. He was mostly on the defense and collecting the boards. But that time he looked really good going to the basket and got fouled.
15 foul on Army, 13-38 remaining first half. Holy Cross with only 2 team fouls. Bencourt in the paint, jumper, but he traveled before he got it off.
Tough play right there, but it looked good. Ted Bencourt attacking the glass. Got called for the travel. Here's where Holy Cross really has to establish the tempo, John. It's on defense.
Passing in the corner, looking up, fakes his man, then pops. No good with a whistle.
That's a tough play right there. Brian left the floor. He went for the fake. He was out of position. And Army is really smart. And of course, Mark Luke, he knows how to get his player up. He looks for the contact. That's why he knows how to go to the line.
Lockhart with the foul on the play. His second. He drills the free throw.
Holy Cross substitution number 20, Damian Ezell.
Damian Ezell into the game. Brian Lockhart, the co-captain, taking a seat on the Holy Cross bench.
And it's looking. He's averaging about 18 points a game, and he leads in assists about 3 a game.
77% free throw shooter, misses the second. Kerr on the other end. Holy Cross can't tip it home. Here comes Luke. Moving quickly. Patterson is mauled on the way up. It was Damian Ezell, who's a very athletic player, trying to block Patterson, but they draw the foul and head to the line.
John Patterson was streaking down there. Look at Luking. He's looking. Luking is looking, and he gets the ball over to John Patterson, who was streaking down the right-hand side. You heard the crowd earlier. I think they were looking for a travel, and I'm not sure if US Air is doing a promotion today, because definitely John Patterson was taking advantage of that plan.
He loves to fly, and it shows, Ernie, right? Is that what USA says? Looking. Rather, Patterson not getting the free throws, and it remains 14-6. First two of the day, the Holy Cross lead double digits at 10.
Damian Ezell could definitely light him up, and he looked good on that elevation.
Heard the strong rebound, and he will do that. Five different players have scored for Holy Cross. Ezell the fake, the shot, Hart the board, and foul as he works down low, Damon Hart. Always a plus to have because he's so good off the glass.
Well, Hart gets the brunt of all the bruises because he gets in there, he brings his pail to the game every day, and what he does is he attacks the offensive glass. I'm telling you, he looks really good. About a year or two ago, he wasn't doing that. He was just getting the rebound, kicking it out, but this time he's looking at the glass and going strong to it.
Teddy Bencourt taking a seat. Walter Brown now in the game for Holy Cross. In the post, puts the ball to the floor, then finds Hart for the jumper. Bit long, Walter skies for the rebound.
Oh, he's playing real aggressive down low.
Ezell, he traveled with it. A little bit of indecisiveness.
Once Ezell gets the ball, it's either he looks inside or he's going to let it fly. He's a quick shooter. He can put points up on the board immediately. As soon as he came in, he put two up there. Just one of the fans that came in and took over the band duties. How do you like that?
Talk about a spirited guy. Wow.
Looked like John Patterson was hurt, and that sends him to the bench. And we got a sub coming in, which is Jamie Upgraft. He's a sophomore from Keystone, Indiana.
Anytime a player is bleeding, NCAA rules mandate that he or she must leave the game to be attended to before they can continue play, and I think that's the case with Patterson. Navy down by 10. They'll work it on offense.
Right now, Holy Cross has a commanding lead, but something was, of course, they can't rest on. But Army's going to definitely work them on defense.
Rebound attempt blocked. We'll get goaltending as Walter Brown skied high, but a little too high.
You got to watch out for Walter because Walter can get up there with the best of them. Here's the turnaround jump shot, and he is up there to send it back to Scituate, where he came from.
Whistle underneath the hoop. Tatum being called. Foul.
What's that pushing? Kind of like that NBA style of ball that West Point plays. It'll definitely wake you up. Can't fall asleep down there on offense, especially underneath the boards. They will hit you. Coach Rainer, I'm pretty sure, went over that in practice. They're going to bump you. They're going to hit you. That's just their style of play.
Tatum has two fouls, and now Holy Cross will be shooting in the bonus. 17 fouls on Army. 11:24 still to play in the half.
Walter Brown has definitely turned around his game, too. He's been called on to pick up some more responsibility, especially with the absence of Feaster. As you see Tom Prissel go out, he's a freshman for West Point. And Walter has been heeding the call. Sophomore, 6'6", about 180, coming out of Boston. Scituate. Got all rookie team honors from the Patriot League last season.
Makes the first one, and we'll get a second so far today. Brown was scoreless. This will be a shot at the second point of the game.
Yeah, he's been in double figures every game this year.
What a great first half he had on the road in the Otis Spunkmeyer Classic against Cal, when Holy Cross put a big scare into the Cal Bears. Corner, Tatum got it. Three-pointer.
Tatum, a three-point shot.
Tatum's tough. Someone you can't forget.
And it's travel from Damon Hart. 18-11, it's a touchdown lead for Holy Cross, 11:01 to play.
Holy Cross sparking into the offense. Probably a good opportunity to get the ball moved around a little bit. Holy Cross dealing the man-to-man pressure. Army demonstrating their stack offense. And this is where it gets tough with Army, because they know how to set screens. And that's what the offense is really based on, is screens.
Luking twisting that time. No good in the hoop. Holy Cross takes it. Ezell feeds to Lockhart in traffic. Yes!
I'm telling you, he got the bumper grind right there. There ain't nothing wrong with that. He's able to knock those two down. You have to earn your points. The referees just don't call those.
Millis with the shot. It's off the mark, and Brown grabs the rebound. Walter, and he traveled. A lot of traveling calls early on.
Well, the other referee basically had a foul. Looked like a foul to me, but Walter Brown, one of the quicker players on the team. He pivots with his right, and yeah, he did the quick jump. Good call. He jumped into the defense.
Steal Holy Cross. Here comes Lockhart. Bounce pass to Brown. Didn't have much room, but it didn't matter.
Wow. Great athlete, showing his athletic ability right there.
Four for Walter. The Holy Cross lead is 11, doubling up Army. That's the biggest of the afternoon, and the Cadets will take a timeout to talk it over. 9:40 to play. Holy Cross up 22-11 on Channel 3.
Hi, I'm Yakov Smirnov. When I was growing up in Russia, I knew about American Eagle. It was a symbol of freedom. It flew anywhere it wanted. Now, eagles and their natural habitat is being endangered. Let's save American freedom. For more information about how to help save the eagles, call the National Foundation to Protect American Eagles, 1-800-2-EAGLES. Thank you.
Check this out, Brian Lockhart, the steal, and Holy Cross finishes.
Look how he squeezed that pass over to Walter Brown. I'm telling you, not any person could do that. And Walter Brown showing his great quickness and his athletic ability in order to squeeze that one up.
Army working now, down 11. Billis, ball on the way up, and he will head to the line. So far for Holy Cross, nice team effort.
Right. When you have a team like Holy Cross has, coaches coming with a lot of quickness, a lot of athletes, strong pump fake. You get about three quarters of the team up there, and they're going for the ball, and he was almost able to cash that one down. That was a good pump fake by Jason Vilas.
Number 45.
Kind of related to Bob.
His first, team's fifth.
Is Coach Bill Reyna.
This is Vilas' first attempt from the free throw line this season.
Yeah, he's a senior center, 6'8", about 220, Indianapolis, Indiana, with the Lawrence North High School. Was a high school standout there.
Gets both of them, and it's 22-13.
Doesn't get that much playing time, but he brings a strong frame to the game, and mostly used on defense.
Brown to Teddy, back to Walter, double team, up with it, short, but it's rebounded by Holy Cross, and then a whistle from the official. We have a foul on the floor.
You get the backup on the offensive boards there by Brian Lockhart. Walter Brown went up first, the acrobatic move, but you got to take it to West Point. If they're going to block the shot, they're going to block it, but you got to take it to them.
Bonus situation, 1-1 for Lockhart. He gets the first. That foul charges it to George Tatum, his third already, and he leaves the game. Coming in, Brad Paulson to replace Tatum.
They definitely need Tatum on the West Point side.
Holy Cross, his strongest free throw shooter, makes both shots, and he drops up 11. Steal Lockhart. a sound offensive player, lays it up, and he's headed to the line again. He liked it so much, he's going to go back.
That's right. Good job by Brian. Brian was able to pick up defensively with his quickness, takes the steal, goes the length of the court. Just a quick steal.
One shot.
Takes it the length of the court, gets fouled on the play by Jamie Upgraff, who came in for Luking. Luking was a little bit injured over there, and Brian makes him pay for the reach.
He completes the three-point play. Lockhart leading Holy Cross in scoring with 9 points. That's better than his 8.6 average, too.
Well, Holy Cross is putting together a good first half so far, and that is in the points department, and also defensively. What they have to do is watch out, because West Point likes to screen. Watch all the confusion down low. Got to talk on defense.
Luking still doesn't have his touch yet. Paulson the rebound, though. Paulson with the leaner, no good. And the follow is dropped home.
We got a follow-up speaker right there. Holy Cross has to stay on the floor. West Point is fundamentally sound. They know that Holy Cross has leapers, and they know how to fake them and get them up there. You got to stay on the floor.
Rojic loses control. Raining picks it off.
Doing a good job there. Raining was able to pick up the loose ball. Look at the length of the court. There's the fake again.
Paulson got Tutwiler in the air and got the foul. Ball didn't drop home, but Paulson will go to the line.
Yeah, that was a big one. Good shot right there with the full court pass. Tutwiler going up strong. They have to stay on the floor. They can't go for those fakes.
First one is no good.
Other than that, Holy Cross is doing a good job defensively, but they got to stay on the ground, and they also have to box out because West Point's getting a second and third opportunities at the glass.
Paulson, the sophomore, just 1 of 8 from the free throw stripe now this season. Leads at 12. Crusaders ahead. Tutwiler up under, stepped in the baseline.
Ran out of room that time. Took it to the glass.
Army basketball.
9 turnovers for Holy Cross.
Well, Holy Cross is coming off a hard-fought loss against Navy Wednesday, 67-63, where Army posted its first Patriot League victory of the season 3 nights ago, rallying from an 18-point second-half deficit to stun Lafayette. So the Patriot League is heating up, John.
Competitive schedule this season. Villas doesn't get it to go, and then it's blocked by Rojic. The official will get Christopher Avalvo on Paulson.
See, Holy Cross is finding themselves in trouble because West Point does a lot of screen and picking down low, which finds themselves in a lot of confusion down there, but West Point's able to follow their shot, and that's what you get right there. Holy Cross is playing defense after the fact, and they're just getting out of position. West Point is just crashing the boards and moving Holy Cross out of there. They're going to have to definitely go back to the drawing board either now or in the second half. Do a better job on defense.
You've mentioned a few times, Ernie, that Holy Cross really doesn't have a true center. However, that's not that big a problem against Army. Army may be one of the shortest Division I teams in the country.
Well, the difference is also is playing smart, too, because Army's been able to get Holy Cross off their feet and create foul situations so that you find yourself at the free throw line a lot as well.
Paulson getting both free throws. 27-17, Keith Driscoll into the game. Pat Tutwiler takes a seat. Driscoll wearing number 42. He had a rough season last year battling a strange sickness, but he's back to full health this year. Rojic running the baseline for two.
That was a good running pass right there by Rojic. And good anticipation by Ted Bettencourt almost caused a violation against Army.
Rojic has 4 now. Luking looking for some points. Doesn't get him. Villas the board. Bettencourt strips it away. Has Lockhart. He'll pull it out. Rojic in the corner. Cross court. Brown from 3. Short. And a foul on Driscoll trying to get position underneath.
That's a tough shot because that's really not Walter Brown's shot, even though he's been working on it. But that's not what his bread and butter is. His bread and butter is like 10 feet and in. And that's what they're really looking for. And right there is the foul by Holy Cross. By Keith Driscoll, just got into the game. He's from Wesley, Mass., went to Boston College High School. And there's Dino Gaudio.
Dino Gaudio, the former assistant of Pete Gillen at Xavier. took the Army job. This is his third season now, and he is slowly turning the program around.
And, of course, Pete Gillen moved on to Providence College.
Are correct. 12-point edge for Holy Cross. Betancourt, they swing it around. Rojic.
Holy Cross being patient on offense. And they're trying to get the look inside and see if they can exploit their height advantage.
Teddy from three. No good. Villas the board.
Holy Cross not getting a lot of opportunities at the glass.
Villas, no good. A rebound. Rojic feeds to Betancourt. Teddy sees daylight. Offensive foul. A little too
That's
strong.
Incredible.
Betancourt, good position by Updegraff.
Updegraff is a heads-up player. Shows his quickness. Goes back to what I said earlier. Just the quickness. Got in position. He knew he wasn't going to block it. And actually, there should be a foul. He's still moving. And the referee is calling offensive before anything happened. That was a tough call right there. Real tough call.
Timeout on the floor. Holy Cross leading 29-17. 6:12 remaining. First half from the Hart Center.
To stop drug use, I think it's going to take more than a just say no campaign. It's so easy to tell somebody just say no, but you've got to give them the power to say no. You have to decide whether to compromise yourself or not. You have to decide whether you're going to help people or whether you're going to hurt people. You have to decide, what's important to you. Where are your priorities? I'm no stronger than the next guy. I've got to be able to make wise decisions in my own life and know that that's what I want to do.
To the Hart Center, and our photographer Tara Baxter, her boyfriend has just showed up. There you see him, the Noi, the Domino's Noi. Tara's been dating him for about 6 months, and I'm glad he could show up today.
Yeah, she wants him for his pizza.
She likes the fringe benefits she gets from that relationship. Of course, earlier today, Holy Cross, the women, they won here today, big 83-29, and none of those players have ever dated the Noi. Six-12 remaining in this one, and the men lead it, 29-17, looking to sweep Army right out of Worcester.
As Holy Cross comes with a little change of the lineup, as you have in the lineup for Holy Cross, Tim Payne, the senior from Glenville, Illinois.
Tim Payne with that vintage 70s headband look.
Yeah, it kind of gives you that old school Bill Walton action.
Villas can't get it. Army having problems from the field.
That's a good rip by Keith Driscoll. That's what Holy Cross has to do more of, is command the defensive boards.
Pass is behind Payne. It's a turnover. Army shooting just 19% from the field, 5 of 26.
Lukens back in the lineup. And of course, last year, Mark Lutie scored 24 points. Against Holy Cross.
Here's Lukens. His touch is escaping him today so far.
It's getting cold, especially he had a good look that time. No one was contesting his shots. And that's pretty good defense when you don't have to contest the shot, especially on a good shooter, and if he's missing like that.
It also should be mentioned that Army is playing without Jason Wan so far today, one of their inside players. He's out with an ankle injury. Driscoll bumping backs with Villas. Loose ball, still on the floor, in the corner, out of bounds, Army's ball.
Army very aggressive. They know how to get position and play smart. That was a tough play right there by Jason Villas. This is where everybody has to get on the floor. Okay. Army's on the floor, Holy Cross is on the floor, and Damon loses out of bounds. Good effort by Damon, showing that he's not afraid to get on the floor.
Jamie Irick back in the game for Army. Brad Paulson takes his seat. He did a decent job. Wall in there.
Holy Cross showing a little zone here. 2-1-2. This will also allow Holy Cross to get out to the perimeter, stop those three-point threats.
Army missing again. Rojic, the rebound. Ira trying to take it from him from behind. Can't do it.
And he was hugging all over him, and I was surprised he was able to get away with it. Well, that's the difference between Holy Cross and Army. Army is known for that aggressive play.
It's a steal now. Irick has some room, and he'll lay it off the glass and in.
That's what's weird I've always noticed over the years, even when I was playing with Holy Cross, was when Army came in and played aggressively, they wouldn't get the calls. But if we tried to do that, they knew that wasn't our style, and it seemed as though we got the calls against us a lot more than Army would have. Here's the bump again. Here's the push.
The reputation certainly preceding the Cadets, and probably helps them out a lot.
Like a Georgetown style player, really aggressive and the bumping. Let's see some of the bumping right here. This Tim Payne with the entry pass, the bump right there. There's another guy that comes over. There's another bump. If you beat your player against Army, you're going to at least greet two more players before you get to the basket. And their goal is to stop you no matter what.
10 team fouls. Georgic misses the first, so Holy Cross will shoot two the rest of the half.
Well, Rojic last year was a Patriot League all-rookie selection. Third leading scorer despite coming off the bench for the first time, first nine games of the year. Expect a lot of things from Rojic. You notice Army all afternoon in the first half have been doing that cross-court pass.
Irick off the nice dish inside for two more.
Nice job by Irick. He's able to split the seams of the zone, took advantage of it, did the dish pass. And Army comes up to score.
Payne to Driscoll from the elbow. Rims in.
That was a big bucket right there. Good job by Payne getting his man up off the glass. Up with the fake. Over to Driscoll.
Looking right over Rojic, and that's what he can do when he's on.
That's not supposed to happen, especially if you have Rojic on you. When he's by himself, he couldn't hit it, but he gets Rojic on him, and he hits it. Tim Payne. Pace is starting to pick up now, John. They're going back to a man-to-man pressure. Actually, they extended the 2-1-2 zone.
Block inside. Willis on the floor, tries to give it up to a teammate, stolen by Holy Cross.
Here we go, we got numbers.
Bencourt to Rojic. Swings right by Luking. Little duck and off the glass.
That's what you call the duck and tuck play. Holy Cross fast break. It seems like it's starting to heat up.
Irick pops for two.
Irick, that's a tough shot by Irick. Primarily a ball handler, not great, but he's solid. He's showing how he was able to hit that baseline jumper.
Irick with six quick points in the last few minutes. It's now 33-26 Holy Cross. And as Irick tries to steal it, the official gets him for his second personal foul.
Irick did a good job. He was in a good position right there to try to make the steal attempt. He's averaging about 22 minutes a game.
Army foul, number 21, Jamie Irick, is second. Chris Rojic with two shots.
Rojic takes his half dozen points to the line. 2:08 remaining. First half of play.
Rojic, his best games basically was scored 13 points in 26 minutes versus LaSalle, including a pair of free throws. 10 seconds remaining this year with AC was up by just 1 point. So he's been putting in a solid performance this year so far.
Rojic makes it 34-26. It's Luging from three, long range. We've gone hard, Betancourt. Here we go, lead pass Lockhart. And he catches the underside of the backboard, but he's fouled in his attempt. So he'll head to the charity stripe.
I'm telling you, you're going to pay. John Patterson, the senior guard. Yeah, he's about 6'1", 180. But, oh, look how he's able to take Brian Lockhart out. Brian has the size, but Brian goes down as well. A little body slam there. The slam dancing down there.
Holy Cross substitution number 44.
Driscoll leaving the game. Walter Brown coming back in. Under 2 minutes to play now.
Lockhart had to take over the leadership role this year as a senior out of Florida. And he's been doing a good job. trying to lead this team.
He's the team leader in free throw percentage, assists, and three-point land. Limited shooting, 7 of 15, though, 47%. Gets one of two, it's 35-26 as Coach Rayner looks on. Has to be pretty content with the first half so far. And Army will take a timeout as they trail by nine. And let's talk a little bit about Holy Cross and what they really need to do right the rest of the season to turn things around and still have a shot at the Patriot League Championship in the tournament and perhaps a trip to the NCAAs if they can win that. I mean, what have they been doing wrong so far, 4-10 to start?
Well, I think, first of all, they're having some problems off the court that aren't being revealed exactly today. And if you check the paper lately, they've been having some problems internally. And I think if they can at least eliminate some of the distractions off the court, maybe they can come on the court, perform, and do what they're supposed to do. Right now, they're coming out of the gate early against Army this afternoon with a good lead, and it looked like they're doing pretty good on offense. But defensively, they're really hurting because Army's all over their back. They're crashing the offensive boards, and they definitely have to start boxing out and not go for the first-hand fakes that they have been going in the early going.
In defense of Holy Cross, their schedule has not allowed them too many home games. They've played some tough games on the road. And at the same time, though, they've lost some embarrassingly rough games to Ivy League schools by big margins, losing to Harvard at home. They didn't look good in that game.
Right.
They also lost to Brown University, I believe. And those are losses that normally in the past, Holy Cross fans would have a tough time living with, but with the nature of the Patriot League and the Ivy League and the way things have changed, I think that's what you should come to expect at this point.
Well, you have to realize, too, that with the absence of Rob Pisa and Gordon Hamilton, the Crusaders come in this season having to replace more than 50% of their scoring from a year ago. Feaster, who was a late Patriot League Player of the Year last year, has 25 points, and Hamilton, second-team All-Patriot, he's factoring about 15 points. That's a big makeup, especially when some of the players didn't have a lot of playing time last year.
Irick to travel. Holy Cross will get it back with a minute 33 on the clock. Teddy Betancourt, defensive pressure coming from Patterson. They get it away though. It's Rojic now to Walter Brown. Shot by Lockhart. No good. Irick with the rebound, and he falls to the floor, tripped in his own feet. Army got a timeout on the other side of the court, Luking. So the coaching staff and Gino Gaudio will discuss their options. 108 remaining, down 35-26. You're watching college basketball on Channel 3.
To stop drug use, I think it's going to take more than a just say no campaign. It's so easy to tell somebody just say no, but you've got to give them the power to say no. You have to decide whether to compromise yourself or not. You have to decide whether you're going to help people or whether you're going to hurt people. You have to decide, you know, what's important to you. Where are your priorities? I'm no stronger than the next guy. I've got to be able to make wise decisions in my own life and know that that's what I want to do.
Back at the Hart Center, and perhaps, Ernie, did you stick out your foot from our table to trip this guy up, Irick?
Well, actually, as you can see, the referee's going by. You just can't see my foot out there, but my foot just got out there just enough
those
to
big
stop
size,
that play.
Size what, 18s?
15s today.
Size 15s.
I was the sixth player today.
And there is our vantage point. And I'll tell you, that's not something to joke about, though. Players going down, especially this week with the scary collapse of Marcus Camby. It's good to see him getting clearance, though, to return to play and continue his outstanding career at UMass.
Well, speaking of injury, as you know, the Cadets have come in here. They lost three players. One is Alex Morris, as you mentioned earlier, with the knee, and also Alfred Forbes. He remains on suspension. There's a lot of suspensions going on with this team between the men's and the women's team. How many in total would you say between injuries and players missing in action?
Well, we had eight suspensions for the women, one for the men, and I believe there are three key injuries, three starters for Army. So they're really down four players on the men's side and eight on the women's side. Dozen total.
I've never heard so many disappearances taking place in the cadet team as much as I've heard this year. But look at Teddy Betancourt.
Will retrieve the wild pass and get nailed all the way up. An intentional foul. called on Army. Patterson just a bit too rough for the officials' liking.
Well, they're familiar with Army's play. And John Patterson, the senior guard, and I'm telling you, they shoot the kill. And Ted Bencourt should have expected this one. He goes strong to the basket. Here he goes. He goes up, does the hammer. They don't allow anybody going strong to the basket. I'm telling you, they can seriously put somebody out. He raises his hand saying, hey, I did the foul, but that's no go. I'm telling you, there's going to be some trouble if they continue to do that.
Army foul on number 11, John Patterson.
Teddy will stand all alone at the line, and he's smiling about it now.
That's probably why the middle sometimes is a little bit vacant there. I would be a little leery going in there myself. I can recall years ago when I was playing, we got into a big scuffle against Army with Larry Westbrook. And I'm telling you, we had to clear the bench. It was like about a minute to go. And it was like the WWF out here. And they were doing it then, and they're doing it now, and they'll continue to do it. That's just their style of play.
Crusader basketball.
Bencourt making one of two. And Holy Cross gets it after the intentional foul. And another timeout taken.
That's interesting.
On courtside.
Timeout, time for timeout. I think that if he was shooting the free throw, I would have took advantage of that time. But maybe there's a special play that's going
to
be designed.
Coach Rayner wanted to talk to his whole team, I assume. And he'll take the time to design a play. 53.7 seconds remaining, and Holy Cross up 36 to 26.
Well, they got a good commanding lead. If they can hold the 10-point edge, that will be, of course, to Holy Cross's advantage. Of course, West Point wants to come in here and drop that. If they can get it down to 8 or 6 within a short span, they will be in favor as well going into the second half.
The Holy Cross men take over the Channel 3 airwaves again this Wednesday night, live at 7:30. Fordham and Holy Cross. The Rams no longer in the Patriot League, though. That's a Patriot League A-10 matchup on Wednesday on Channel 3. Bencourt the miss, Army the rebound. They are down 10 points, 45 seconds to play.
I think that little hammering, the early timeout, kind of intimidated them a little bit. You get a little leery going in there. And that's okay, because we don't want to get hurt here.
Ezell staring down Luking. Now Bencourt and the double team on the floor. Jump ball, possession arrow to Army.
Good job by Bencourt. He snuck around the weak side. Luking was not looking for Bencourt. Bencourt comes around and ties him up, and the arrow goes to it. The Cadets.
Unofficially, Luking with just 7 points. The average is 17.7 a game. Has been off the mark. Luking double teamed. Patterson dishes back. Hyrick loses it. Now it's loose, and Damon Hart picks it off. Here's Ezell. Has teammates. Rojic will take it himself. And it drops in, 10 seconds to play, 38-26.
Good body control by Rojic. He has a big frame. He was able to control his body to knock the two off the glass.
Steal by Bencourt, and he'll let the time wind right down. Teddy content with that. His team up a dozen at the half. Holy Cross looking good, and just 20 minutes away from making it a purple sweep here at the Hart Center this Saturday afternoon. That'll do it for first half action. We're back with halftime activities right after this on WGMC TV3. And on a few occasions, maybe even more than a few in the first half, he came through.
That's right. And look what one of the times that he did do it. Came up, anticipated the steal, takes it the length of the court. But at the same time, it looked like he was going to pay the price, but he stuck with the concentration, was able to knock it off the glass. And I believe that was a foul on the play as well.
Army cut into the Holy Cross lead just a bit during a stretch in the first half. They are down by 12 now, but it could have been a much bigger lead had Army not stayed with it and stayed with their disciplined, aggressive style that we've talked about a little bit that has been their hallmark over the years.
Well, if you look at the comparison, okay, in reference to the scoring drive, we see Army attacking the glass right here. Now, here's Holy Cross is one of their problems. Over the top, not really in a strong position in a lot of the opportunity, but right there was the time where they crashed the offensive glass and was able to do something.
We look at the scoring rundown just handed to us. Ryan Lockhart leading the way with 10 points for Holy Cross. Chris Rojic with 9. Teddy Betancourt following with 6 points. Other scorers for the Cross: Damian Azell, 2. Damon Hart, 3. Pat Tutwiler, 2. Driscoll with 2. And Walter Brown, a pretty quiet first half, only 4. But his team's doing them pretty well without his big scoring.
Well, they definitely need Walter Brown to step up. Walter Brown has been reluctant to stay on the outside, but I like to see him play a little bit more on the inside. As you see the purple posse go off here at the Hart Center. And I like to see him play inside because I think that's where his strength is slamming the ball, blocking some shots, and on the offensive boards, of course, attacking it like Damon Hart has been doing.
Let's take a look at the halftime stats, Ernie. Holy Cross with a big advantage from the field percentage-wise.
Well, that's where you have to contribute to some of the fast break points where the Holy Cross was able to get some layups as the free throw percentage, because, of course, when they got the layups, they had another opportunity to go to the free throw line because they were fouled. So as you can see the difference right there in the points department, as well as the difference in the rebounding department. But Army is still, despite the turnovers, Army has 14-10 to Holy Cross. They're still in this ball game.
And another key stat to take a look at, of course, personal fouls. No one really in trouble on the Holy Cross side. Tutwiler and Lockhart do have 2 apiece. But for Army, it's John Patterson with 3 and George Tatum with 3. So they are both in jeopardy of getting very close to falling out.
Well, they like Tatum. Tatum is a freshman swingman for the Cadets, and he showed a strong showing in his varsity debut, which is this season. He's from Clinton, North Carolina, native, ranks 3rd on the team in scoring. He averaged about 8 points, about 5 rebounds a game. And he started about 12 of Army's 14 games. And he's averaging about 27 minutes. So they expect big things from Tatum.
Mark Lukic from Army took 11 shots in the first half. 10 of them from 3-point land, hit on only 2 of them. He has a total of 7 points with 1 from the line. That leads Army 6 points for Jamie Eyrick. Back to live action in the second half, a full 20 minutes. Still ahead in this one. Holy Cross up a dozen. Inside pass, Betancourt has it drop into his hands, but no good in the layup.
As we get going here, and looks like Army's a little bit cold coming out with the wild shot. Now here's Holy Cross's form of fast break.
Rojic to Walter. Easy lay-in.
Nice control by Walter. Nice job by Holy Cross getting out on the fast break. And what made that fast break work was that they were able to fill the lanes.
Walter has a half dozen. Came in averaging 17-4 a game. Jumper from Tatum doesn't go. Brown the rebound. Walter averaging 5.5 a game this season.
That was a nice club snatch by Walter Brown. Walter Brown can definitely get up.
And we have yet to see a Brown dunk today, though he can do.
I'm waiting to see some highlight film by Brown.
He can do that, and he can do it in a monstrous way, too. Tutwiler right around his man. Ops to pass it.
Holy Cross being very patient. Very patient on offense, then.
Rebound taken down by Rainey.
Holy Cross settling for the jumper on offense. Maybe he can probably get something down low.
Looking from 3, he's now 2 of 11 from 19-9.
Wow, he is really cold. Even though he's launched three-pointers, he has 244 three-pointers throughout his 3-year West Point career.
Acrobatic move by Rojic on the other end. The shot didn't go, and it remains 40-26, 18-10 to play second half.
Well, he continued to talk about looking. He established a new Patriot League record last season with 98 long field goals. But today, 2.
Millis fouled on the way up. And the big guy, the biggest guy Army has, 6'8". He will head to the free throw line. First foul of the half for either team.
Some would probably say that was probably a wasted foul. He gets out there. It's a soft one as well. Tutwiler gets up there, gets called for it. But I really don't think he's a threat. And that probably was a wasted foul. So, but Jason goes to the line, is able to recoup.
Tutwiler has 3 now.
And they're looking for a lot more leadership from Tutwiler as well, the junior forward out of St. Paul, Minnesota. He earned a start this year against Colgate after coming off the bench in the games.
Millis makes 1 of 2. Correct that. He get both of them. 40-28.
That's a good job right there. Rozic was able to catch a streaking Brian Lockhart. He took advantage of his large frame down low and was able to squeeze that one up. And that's where Holy Cross's bread and butter could be, is down low if they could get some of their big frames down there and get in good position. Look at the height difference right there, as you can see. There's a foul call on the baseline against Walter Brown. He's trying to shut down George Tatum. We talked about George Tatum a little bit earlier.
Lockhart is leading the way in scoring for Holy Cross with 12. It's above his average by a good 9 points. Looking off the pick in the paint now. Twisting block by Walter. Almost falls in. Rebound follow by Villas is good.
Villas is around the basket. Pretty much the garbage man on this team, but he's been playing pretty solid. He's been attacking the boards on the offensive end as well as playing some good defense. Good job by Villas.
In the corner, Betancourt popping from three, draining it.
Well, that's the shot he was looking for in the first half, and he finally got it to go in the second half.
Teddy has 9, the lead's at 15.
Teddy's one of the few people on the team that can hit that three. I would say Ezell can do it as well as Lockhart.
Strong drive by Tatum, they get two back, 45-32.
Tatum's coming back, he's doing a good job. The freshman is the swing person, recently just started. Showing why he did, working hard into getting to the starting lineup, and did a good job there on the offensive glass.
Last court, Rogic from three, short on the jumper.
Looks like Holy Cross is allowing themselves to just be satisfied with the outside shooting, and outside shooting really hasn't been in their favor in this game, and I really like to see them go down low a lot more, being an inside player myself, of course.
A little bit biased. Looking from three, missing again. This may be one of his worst three-point shooting days in quite a while.
I would say he continues to have the green light. I think that green light must be a switch must be broke over there on the bench. I think the coach should put on the red light for him for right now.
At least the yellow light. They do go inside finally, Ernie, and it's a foul as Rozic draws it.
Well, if you notice all the time, if you rewind the film and go back, all the times that Holy Cross had an opportunity to go down low, Army is not going to allow you to score down low. Either you're going to score or you're going to get fouled. And it just comes down to Holy Cross concentrating on going low. It's either they're going to score or they're going to find themselves at the free throw line. And they should take advantage of that. But I don't know if the players want to get beat up all day as well, too. It's called sacrifice.
It's the weekend. They want to take it easy. It's Saturday. Kick back.
Yeah, that's true, too.
Rozic not a bad free throw shooter at 72%. He'll try to hit the second one. His team up 13. And he nails it. Rozic now with 10 points. He's in double digits. Army, second chance opportunity. Doesn't go, but they do get the whistle and the foul.
Army's just squeaking in there, and that was Rainey. Iranian attacking the glass. And look at the Army players. They don't attack the offensive glass. Where's Holy Cross at? There's one or two players in there. But Holy Cross is definitely going to have to get some bodies on these West Point players, but they are attacking the glass. And Holy Cross at this time does have the height advantage as well as the size advantage. And it's Dean Ogotti.
John Kerr comes back in the game for Holy Cross. Walter Brown going over to talk to Coach Rayner.
Now this is the perfect opportunity. Look at number 45, John Kerr, sophomore, Grafton, Mass. He was at the halftime interview. Big frame right there, and he can contest with number 54, Jason Villa. Rozic, not bad, in reference to his size as well. He can mix it up. The junior forward, 6'7", 220, Boston, Mass. And I think that's what Holy Cross is going to have their success if they pull some of that beef around.
Rainey gets both the free throws. He has 6. Rainey's at 12 right now. 15:45 to play. Rozic swings it to Teddy. Betancourt almost took an extra step. Shot clock down to 14. Lockhart pops. Gets it. 3-pointer for Bryan.
That's what Lockhart can do. And that will open up the ball game if they can pound it down low, and then what will happen is the outside game will open up as well. That was a nice three by Brian deep in the corner.
15 points for Lockhart. Ball tied up. Whistle. And there's a jump ball situation. Possession arrow two. Army. And Brian Lockhart probably woke up this morning and thought, what a day I'm going to have defensively having to defend Mark Luking. But really, he's had a great offensive day. Luking's been cold.
Yeah, Luking has been a big surprise for this team, but he continues to have the green light. He continues to let them fly. And actually, he's hurting the team as he continues to shoot. But you know what they say, if you're in a shooting slump, what do they say, John?
You got to shoot out of it. He's got to take a seat on the bench, as is the case right now for Luking, I think.
Yeah.
I never get in shooting slumps, Ernie, though, so I don't have to worry about that in my pickup games.
Well, do you play?
Rogic with an easy two. I hit everything.
Oh, okay.
Don't miss a single shot over at the Greendale Y.
I heard about that. I heard you're all Greendale.
First team all Greendale. As well Tim as Young and I.
Yeah. I heard Tim Young always alley-oops to you. You'd be throwing it down over to brothers over
Sometimes
there.
Sometimes the other way around, you know. Tim can get up there for a guy who's 5'4".
There's Ted Bencourt leading the pack. If the Holy Cross continues to do this, I expect a timeout. And it may be a runoff like how the women's team is doing.
Teddy has 11, the 19-point lead, the biggest of the day for Holy Cross. And you predicted the timeout. Army trailing 53-34, 14-11 remaining in the second half.
Hey, you.
Right now, in some school districts, third graders are learning how to solve this equation. And in some school districts, sixth graders are learning. But there are still some school districts where seniors will receive a diploma without ever having to face the question. Insist on high academic standards.
Brian Lockhart has 15 to lead the way, but Chris Rogic has 12, and he's coming through here on the miss on Bencourt shot.
He's skying on the offensive glass, and that's what they're going to need more of. Get some of that big body presence in there. I believe in a big body presence down there, and he showed that right there. At the same time, the Cadets haven't really fared well here at the Hart Center. They don't get too much success here, and I think the last time they got a win here was out of Kevin Houston in the class of 80. And that's when he wrote a 40-point effort by him when the Cadets won 67-66. But ever since then, they dropped about 10 straight here at the Hart Center, and of course, 9 to the Crusaders.
Holy Cross led by 12 at the half. The lead is now 19 thanks to a 15-6 run here in the second half. Aggressive defense from Holy Cross.
Now here they go. Now they're giving the Cadets a little bit of their own medicine there. You'd be surprised how the Cadets respond when you start being aggressive back to them. Look at that lane there. It's wide open.
Bencourt was surprised he had so much time and space and saw the hoop and dropped it in for two.
Well, credit Damon. Damon was able to get that team up, get it back to Ted, and Ted took advantage of the lane. He went down the lane, and they're pushing, and Holy Cross is adjusting to the aggressiveness. I noticed that, because they're looking at Kerr over there, and Kerr really put one of the Cadets on the floor. He gave a foul, as they would say.
That's John's second. Steal by Kerr now, trying to make up for it. Has Bencourt, didn't see him, though.
But it caught Damon.
Big guy not used to running the break.
That was his first steal of the year. Because Damon posting down low. There you go.
Walter the follow. So athletic and so strong in the glass.
Holy Cross's athleticism is starting to shine here. With 13 to go.
Brown has 8. This is taking shape as Holy Cross is strongest game of the year so far, I'd say. They're up 57-34.
And the trapping out there in the backcourt as well. Everyone's attacking the defensive boards. Another opportunity by Army. They just haven't really capped on commanding the defensive boards. But now Holy Cross showing a little bit of pressure on the outside.
Villas misses the easy one. Followed by Rainey is good in the foul. That breaks an 11-0 Holy Cross run.
Holy Cross still having a tough time on the defensive boards. They got to protect their glass. And if everyone box out and go through the boards, it'll make it a lot easier for them. As you check out the replay here, the Cadets are hovering around there like bees, and they continue to stay on the offensive glass, and they continue to pound you and jump over your back. Put a body on them. It's Ted Bencourt taking a breather. Bill Rayner to the right, talking to him, and Coach Dowd to your left.
Rady makes good in the free throw.
Well, you know, Rady did not begin the season on the varsity roster. He was held without a field goal and managed to post a career-high 10 points and 7 rebounds, 29 minutes. In the last outing with Army.
Coaching staff likes his hustle, though.
From Burlington, North Carolina.
We're going to get a foul on Holy Cross. John Hightower, the freshman in the game, pushing Patterson right to the deck and foul on the Crusaders.
Well, I suspect in the last 12:30 to go is a lot of pushing and shoving, as has been taking place throughout the course of the whole basketball game. But now Holy Cross is adjusting, and they're going to start pushing back. It should be pretty interesting, and I like that.
20-point lead for Holy Cross. That was their first turnover of this half. That's a sign you have to love to see if you're a Purple fan. Lockhart's going to take it himself in dish. Now Walter after one more pass. Easy shot.
There's the shot he was looking for. Credit that to Brian Lockhart, bringing it out of the pack, leading the fast break, stopping, creating something to happen, something opened up for Walter.
Brown, 6 in the second half to increase his total to 10 today. Holy Cross up 22 points. They get 19, though, as Patterson nails the 3.
John Patterson a little bit late, but better late than never.
Johnny Kerr, an easy bucket. He gets his first 2 of the day.
The big man's getting involved in the ball game.
Kerr had a tough freshman season, as you heard at halftime, but has played a lot more, and this is sophomore season. Looking from 3, yes, his second of the day.
Looking, a 3-point shot.
Looking, he's starting to heat up. You gotta watch out for him. He's averaging about 32 minutes a game, and he'll check it up there.
John Hightower, number 22, is a freshman guard for Holy Cross from Dorchester, 6'1", 175. Bucket for Damon Hart.
Damon Hart coming off the position from the Cadets. Could have been an offensive call there, but it wasn't, and Damon even put 2 in the coffin, too.
Army coach Dino Gaudio still holding out hope that his team can come back. Down 20, 10:52 to play from the Hart Center.
Rabies in New England has reached epidemic proportions within the raccoon population. It is estimated that 2/3 of cats and 1/3 of dogs in this area are either not vaccinated for rabies or are improperly vaccinated. Your pets may bring this fearsome disease into the safety of your home and family. Vaccinate both your dogs and cats. It's the law.
Right back at the Hart Center. Army with the ball, but down 20 points.
Now watch this on the offensive end.
As long threes, no good.
As those threes continue to try to go up there. But you notice on the offensive end, when they try to get open for their shots, they set the picks, and they set the pick hard. And if you don't get by Jason Vila, you're going to pay for it. And he sets them hard and high.
If I had to guess, I'd say Luking is about 2 of 16, 2 of 17 from 3. Not too many players would keep shooting if they were performing that poorly, as Hart gets 2 more, similar to the basket he just had. But Luking keeps on gunning.
Well, Damon Hart is gunning right now, and he's got the feeling, and he's hot. And he's 2 for 2 in that regards. And look at the trap over there.
There's
Lee's open the weak side.
On the other end, it's out of bounds, off of Army. Holy Cross to take it. Under 10 now to play, 9:59 from the Hart Center.
Mike Rainey jumping in, and Mike Rainey, 6'5 from Burlington, North Carolina. They made a lot of roster changes this year, Army. Army's still adjusting and getting their act together.
pushing down low. John Kerr is getting bumped by Army, and it's a personal foul on the Cadets.
It's good to see John Kerr down there getting low. As you see him streaking down the elbow, and who else is there except Jason Vila pushing him out the way there. A lot of bumping and moving down there. The referee's coming to step in because it's getting a little bit out of hand. But that's the Army style of play, John. That is to push you. And, of course, they're in shape. Look at some of the guns on some of those players.
Alder Brown right off the pass for two. And I get the sense, Ernie, Army's not your favorite school in your playing days. You must have had a big rivalry with these guys.
Oh, we definitely did. We averaged about 1.2 fights a game against those guys.
Biggest lead of the day, 67-43. Rainey inside, though, two back. He has 11.
We used to give a few fouls. We used to make him pay the price. We used to give it right back. Make sure Kerr is down low. He can give away a few. Now, Ezell's in the game, and he can let it fly, too. He's a three-point threat.
Hart doesn't get that one to drop in. Clear out underneath, and it's a foul on Paulson.
Grant Paulson, the sophomore, trying to control the boards, but it looked like Holy Cross is giving a little taste of the offensive glass, too. You got Kerr down there, Damon's in there, Walter Brown's in there. But Paulson gets called with the foul, and he was crowded by Crusader players.
Three team fouls now on Army, six on Holy Cross as Brown takes it to the hole, but the whistle before he can reach the bucket.
Especially when Holy Cross got the athletes out there and the quickness, probably be a good opportunity for them to spread the offense. Army plays so tight that you could probably get a couple of people streaking back door.
Paulson, his second straight foul. Ezell from about 25 feet long.
He's from Ohio. He's not afraid to let it go.
These Ohioites, they are not afraid to let it go at all.
Not at all.
Do a lot of long-range shooting out there.
Ezell will get in there for a few minutes. He may play like 5 to 10 minutes a game. He'll touch it maybe 8 or 9 times, and 8 or 9 times it'll go.
Holy Cross 53% from the field, 27 of 51. Army 14 of 52, that's just 27%. Betancourt around up to grab. On the rebound, Hart is fouled. That is hand tapped underneath.
Now Hart has taken over, and that's what you like to see. Damon's come in, he's commanded the offensive glass right now, and he's creating all kinds of havoc for Army. And Army's down low. Holy Cross is starting to crash the boards. This is Kerr, this is Damon taking control, going up, and there's the foul.
Zell feeds to Kerr. John has it stripped, but picked up by Betancourt under the hoop. Back to Kerr, double team through the defenders, and elbowed his way out of there. John Kerr can't believe the call, and David Hart will have to restrain him as he barks at the official.
They are jumping all over Kerr. Check this out. You got Vila down there. Who else is digging in there? You got everybody down there. Brad Paulson's in there. And Kerr just says, all I want is some room. I just want to get on the scoring board. I just want to get a couple of points. I'm minding my own business.
And forget about Anthony Hopkins and Nixon. How about Brad Paulson playing the acting role right there, taking the dive to the floor? Give him the nomination for the Oscar.
Yeah, I think that's right around the corner, too, so he thinks that someone's watching him. The scouts are here today. And I notice the crowd is a little bit quiet here today. I don't hear a lot of noise here. Usually you hear some cheers and some shouting here.
Holy Cross has been in control for a while. Perhaps the fans quieted a bit by that after some early excitement. It's 67-45, 8 minutes even to play. Holy Cross up 22. Luking leaning in towards the hoop all alone. Guess what?
Highlight
Showtime Walter.
Oh, he missed it.
And let's see if Coach Bill Rayner decides Walter Brown should come out of the game for that little miss.
That's okay, though. It was exciting. Look how far he takes off from the free throw line. Just outside the free throw. Oh, the double clutch pump, and ooh, he had it. It looked good, though. ESPN, oh, well, we can't send that in for the ESPYs.
We had been hoping for it. We knew a Brown dunk was on the way. Unfortunately, it doesn't go down, but the anticipation was still exciting.
We were waiting for a Brown throwdown.
And Walter comes out of the lineup. Phil Robot tells us, Ernie, you used to do stuff like that. Any truth to that?
I used to throw them down, yeah. Rarely missed, though, Rob. Rarely missed, but I used to throw down a few.
Betancourt at the line, gets the free throw, he'll get another.
And look at Walter's talking about it. Coach is not looking that way. I think there's a detour sign over there. But that's okay, though.
Teddy gets both.
That's a good opportunity to look at Carlos Clark. Now, Carlos Clark is a story because I believe after his sophomore year, he transferred. He was here early. He was going to pick up the rebounding. And he actually was having a good offensive stint, too, when he was here at Holy Cross. He transferred, actually took some time off, went back to Tennessee, and now he's here today.
His first action this afternoon, number 35, Carlos Clark, the junior from Chattanooga, Tennessee. And he was a starter that sophomore year. So when he finally gets all the rust off his game, he could be a big-time contributor for this team down the stretch.
Right. And look at Jason Kerr goes to the bench as well. Puts in a good performance. But look at the body of Carlos Clark. He presents a little bit of center physique, but mostly he's a forward. Now this is where you have to watch out for Army. They like to do a lot of picking and switching, and you got to play back off the Army player.
The dribble. Turner. Army.
Now it'll be interesting to see what he can do on offense. He brings a big physique presence to the game. Holy Cross pretty much in control right now.
Ezell, the up fake, the dribble, drive, shot, no good. And Hart, he likes that spot.
Yeah. Really impressed with Damon. He's really looking to score this year. A little different than what we are accustomed to seeing him do.
Starting contact.
Starting to get real physical out there.
Chippy at this point.
I think Holy Cross was a little bit rattled in the beginning. They shouldn't have expected anything different, but I think they made the adjustment coming out of halftime. It seems as though they're getting into the flow of the aggressiveness play, and now it's starting to come into their favor, and Army's not being able to take advantage of it. And this Dino, he realizes that his physique and his physical play is going against him right now. So he says, I think I'll take a seat.
Army's substitution number 44, Paul Schaefer.
19 turnovers. As Carlos Clark heads to the line, 38% from the stripe in the season. Shot off the miss doesn't go. And Army starting to clear the bench at this point. They're going to foul on Army. Dino Gaudio better watch out or he's going to get a technical call on him. He is irate on the Army bench.
That's a perfect example of a setup right there. Ezell must have knew that was coming. And he played it up a little bit, but I'm pretty sure it still hurt at the same time. Now check this out. Ezell must see it. Look at this. That's a takeout right there by Rosawa. And he is flat on his back and then some. That's ridiculous. That's Paul Schaefer, a sophomore, giving away a foul.
20 turnovers now for Army. That'll kill you. It was Paul Schaefer who set that pick and got the foul just in the game. The sophomore center, 6'7".
There's 6:34 to go. I can see Holy Cross giving something back pretty soon.
Ezell looking for his fourth point. Gets it. And it's the biggest lead of the day for Holy Cross. 26 points. Timeout on the floor, 6:34 to play. Holy Cross in control from the Hart Center.
Hey, Billy boy, saw your picture in the paper yesterday. Coming down the ladder, carrying twins in one arm. Just another day's work. Modest guy.
Hey, I've saved lives too, you know. Lots of them.
You?
Me.
How do you save lives?
I donate blood. It's safe, easy, and only takes a few minutes to be a real hero.
You can help save a life. Call your community blood center or hospital and make an appointment to give blood. It's one of the most important things you'll ever do.
Energizer Bunnies, those guys still going, still dancing at it with 6:34 remaining.
You know something, the Purple Posse has grown from period to period.
I think you're right. Gaining in popularity. 71-45, Holy Cross leading Army. Second half action from the Hart Center. Tim Payne back in the game. John Hightower, Damian Azell, Keith Driscoll, and Carlos Clark, the five for Holy Cross. Another pick set by Schaefer. This time, though, the foul is on Holy Cross. And Army is, I think, not afraid to instigate.
Right. But see, now notice how he's out. He looks. He knows it's there. He knows it's there. You got to know it's coming. He got hit the first time. He knows it's there. The referee anticipated it. And he's like, hey, he really didn't contest it.
1-1.
He was able to get away with the award the first time. The second time, it was pretty much anticipated. But that's okay, though. It's good to give it to an Army player.
Schaefer makes the shot.
This Coach Bill Rayner. Say, not bad, Ezo. Give it back to him.
Holy Cross, 50% for the half. 13 of 26. Army, just 30% at 6 of 20. Another free throw. Make it 71-47. Saders up.
Now here's a new kid on the block we don't really get a chance to talk much about, which is John Hightower, the freshman guard out of Dorchester, Mass, with the Thayer Academy, selected as Patriot League Preseason Rookie of the Year by College Sports Magazine. And he made his debut back at Dartmouth. And he scored about 2 points in 12 minutes and 4 points in 14 minutes against BC, and scored 6 points in 11 minutes at Yale. So as a freshman, they expect a lot of big things out of him, especially with Brian Lockhart leaving after this year.
And I get the sense by going to a few Holy Cross practices that he is one of Bill Rayner's favorites. Coach likes to joke around with John at practice and have a lot of fun with him.
I think he has a good attitude, has a good approach to the game, and he brings in a little bit of leadership too in his early role as a backcourtsman.
One of two for Hightower, 72-47, coming up on 6 minutes to play. Short of the jumper. Holy Cross gets it.
Good job by Hightower. One of the few people that didn't leave their feet today. In reference to going for the fake.
Mark Luking back in the game. There he is for Army. He was supposed to be the guy to keep them in the game, but he has struggled all day long.
Well, if you compare team leaders, Mark Luking was averaging about 18, and Walter Brown was averaging about 18. And I don't think neither player has close to 18 today.
First goal to Izell, now to Tim Payne. Carlos Clark working on Rainey, up and in.
Nice move by Carlos Clark. He was calling for the ball down low. Was very patient, wasn't able to get it on the block. With some ball movement, was able to work with it and scored two.
Looking from three.
That's incredible. He was in that same spot 5 minutes ago.
Looking has 13 despite the shooting woes. He grabs the rebound. 74-50, Holy Cross up by 24, 5:10 to play. And Looking throws it to Dino Gaudio. Gaudio, though, had not officially checked into the game, so turnover.
Not at all. He doesn't appreciate that assist as well. He has a long way to go. And we're going to sit here for another 5 minutes and see what Holy Cross is going to do. And watch out some of his physical play down low. I don't think the story is over yet with some of his physical play. Nice steal.
Second straight steal for Luking. He'll take it alone to the bucket. Blocked by Driscoll. Second chance, no good.
Oh!
Blocked again! Follow three-pointer. Rims around. Doesn't drop. Loose ball. Whistle. Oh. And we have a foul on Army. Keith Driscoll. Two blocks in a matter of seconds. And now we've got some fisticuffs.
This is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about. Get in there. It's coming.
Army is an emotional team. That ball went out of bounds near the Army bench, and some words were exchanged between the teams. Mike Rainey involved.
Here it comes. I told you. I'm sorry, but my Agent Orange is starting to act up in me again. That was ridiculous. When they go for the ball, the Army player was diving out of bounds. At the same time, he's trying to take out the legs of Damon again.
Let's look at these blocks from Driscoll.
This is where the series began. And look at where he gets the block coming from behind. Great job. Knocks it to an Army player. He missed it high off the glass. And watch this. He comes out of bounds, comes in, sends it back almost to the press table. I was waiting for it. And all of a sudden, we're going to see the jump shot by Tom. But we don't see it. And then after that, that's when things are interrupted. And that's when things interrupted after that.
Seem to be calmed down just a bit now as the officials are talking to
the captains,
captains Luking and Lockhart.
That was inevitable. I told you that was going to come before the game was out. If not the girls' game, at least the men's game.
Forget about the amazing Kreskin. How about the amazing Floyd? Calling that as early as the first half.
They were overdue. They were overdue. Now I think they've come to a head in reference to the aggressive play. They're both hopefully going to cut it out. The referees have stepped in finally. They're going to set the tone from, we've got 4:42. Makes no sense anyone getting hurt, especially with the commanding lead that Holy Cross has. So hopefully get the players to calm down a little bit.
There's a nice shot of Damian Gazelle. This is the first free throw. The lead stays at 24.
Damian's a little cold today. He's usually on fire, and he can put points on the board real quick for you.
Tough bounce. Doesn't go.
Probably still a little bit shaken up from the pushing around. He's been getting the brunt end of all the aggressive play. There's the trap. Nice aggressive trap by Holy Cross.
He'll get a foul as Luking controlled it on Hightower or Driscoll. Tough to tell in the corner.
I think Holy Cross does a good job of trapping. Look at big Driscoll getting out there. Almost left his feet. Stays, keeps his composure. A little bit of trouble there. But Mark Luking keeps his composure as well and creates a foul. And there's Damon Ezell from Ohio. And I think he's really got banged around the most today, especially after that last time out.
Chris Shea is now in the game for Holy Cross as Damian takes a seat after being beat up. There's a shot of Chris Shea. Free throw's good. Make it 74-52, 4.5 to play. Shea will run the offense. Shea is from Marlboro, Massachusetts, and played basketball at Worcester Academy. So a local guy getting a shot here as we wind down. After this game, Holy Cross will move on to its next matchup versus Cornell coming up on the 22nd. And of course, they play two nights later against Fordham. And that game is on Channel 3 live at 7:30 Wednesday night. Holy Cross meeting Fordham. Fordham, of course, the team that eliminated Holy Cross and Rob Feaster from the Patriot League tournament last season. Feaster was injured in that game at West Point, but Holy Cross gets another shot at the Rams. It's Wednesday night, 7:30. All the live action, myself and Ernie, right here on Channel 3.
I like that Holy Cross-Fordham matchup because we used to go toe-to-toe with those guys too as well. Close to fights, but not as close as you'll get playing the Cadets.
Tim Payne off the mark. And Driscoll again. Three super blocks. His stock is rising today.
Definitely. Super D. I tell you, the big people came to play today, starting with John Kerr.
Shea loses it, steal by Priscell. Gives it up in the corner. Up to Graf. Now inside.
Oh, it's going in!
And we're going to get a foul. Keith Driscoll is playing out of his mind.
Get that stuff out of here. Return to sender. This is my house, Driscoll's house. And look where he's coming from. If you look at all his blocks, he's coming from behind. He got all ball there. And the referee just had to find some white jersey because he says, wait a second, that's incredible. You can't be doing that.
There looked to be a little contact, but it was all ball with his hand.
Driscoll getting the crowd excited. And I think Army's thinking maybe two times, maybe four times on not going inside anymore because Driscoll's coming out of nowhere with his cape.
Schaefer gets the roll. He now has 4 points. 74-54, 20-point edge. 3:30 to play. There's Hightower. Whistle as he moves towards the bucket, and there's a foul on Army.
Hightower got some good ball movement, some good control. Stays within himself. Doesn't do anything foolish with the ball. Gets fouled and has an opportunity to go to the glass. And I notice you're looking at the program. Today's program has a picture of Walter Brown throwing it down. And I think that's one of the times he made one.
That was from last year's Bucknell game that was here on Channel 3. Walter had a couple great dunks that afternoon.
Oh, that looks, that's a Sports Illustrated shot right there. I wish I could show it to you guys out there, but I'm going to get him to sign my program after this.
Hey. And let it be known that Ernie Floyd, people still remember this guy. Kids were mobbing him for autographs just before the women's game. I kid you not.
I remember.
He was charging 10 bucks a pop, I might add.
Yeah, the IRS was in the corner, too, looking at me. We got scouts here, so I was like, no, kid, not today. Good call there. Army continues to attack. It looks like they're brought in some more brass. And Paul Schaefer. Paul Schaefer's just a little bit feisty. As Justin Johnson let the ball go. The reserves are in right now. And Holy Cross is banging the boards. And give me that. Get out of here. It's reserve play now.
Hightower by his man. Now gives up to Shea. Local kid. Can't make good, though. Lead pass to Johnson. Clark is back. Ball loose. Johnson gets it back up over Driscoll. No good. His own rebound. Blocked. I think Driscoll got another hand on that. Blocked again.
Driscoll's
hitting for breakfast.
Definitely out of control. There's one. Well, prior to that, he had another one. And Tim Payne gets caught with that one. And I think that's one of the things that's...
And the bench likes it.
Driscoll's setting up a little detour down low there, and he's making the traffic go the other way. Holy Cross put in a good afternoon effort, and I'm pretty sure Coach Reyna is very pleased. And Holy Cross coach in the second year. He's a 74 graduate from Dartmouth College. Scored, he's in the 1,000-point club. Scored 11-29. Selected as an All-Ivy League Rookie of the Year. He's been coaching Division I since 1976. Coach Billy Reyna of Holy Cross.
2:20 to play now, 75-54. Tim Payne to inbound it. And Ian Dombrowski will check into the game for Holy Cross. He wears number 32.
Yep, as the reserves go a little bit deeper.
Payne from the corner. And it's short. And check out the jersey number 14 has on. That is a black t-shirt underneath. It makes it look like one full piece. Strong move by Purcell. And it's 75-56.
That was a good job to attack the glass, and a good no foul too as well, because what that does is stop the clock. There you go, the bodysuit.
I don't know, it looks like they had to suit up the team manager, but that is actually Babe Kwasniak. He's a freshman from Ohio, Cleveland, Ohio, 6 feet 170, getting his first action today.
Yeah. Maybe he knows Ezel. Who's the manager? All manager team.
Johnson in the purple paint. Driscoll gets a hand on it, but a foul that time.
Now you get a chance to see the reserves come in and show what they have. And pretty soon we're going to be going into March Madness, and this is a good time for Holy Cross to get a quick look at his the reserves. And is Dino waiting to leave the Hart Center, because he hasn't really fared that well here at the Hart Center over the years, even though he's been newly appointed to Army position.
Holy Cross's other freshman recruit, Malik Waters, is in the game. He's the Baldy over there on the far side of the lane. You'll get a chance to see him in a second. He's like a Sweet Pea-type character. We'll see what he's got here in the final minute, 35. 75-58, Holy Cross. Loose ball, and it's going to stay Crusader basketball.
Well, as they continue to play here, you know, in the early going, Coach Reyna had to find the right combination in putting his Crusaders together, and that was when junior Keith Driscoll from Wellesley, Mass. Started the first five games, and sophomore John Kerr came up as well. And next field was Carlos Clark and Patrick Tutwiler, and I think he may have found the combination today.
Purcell, that's good for 3 points. Got to cut the lead to 75-61, and it may end up looking a little bit closer in the final score than it really was all day. 14 points right now. Waters double-teamed and has it stripped away. Purcell on Johnson, lead pass. Paulson can't get it to drop in. Shea the rebound. And loses it right away, Army to get it back. 59-7, 59.7 remaining, 75-61. And there's a look at Malik Waters, who comes to Holy Cross all the way from New Mexico, the first Crusader recruit ever from that state. Wozniak misses on the jumper. And here comes Waters. Dishes to Driscoll. Contact and a foul underneath the hoop.
Yeah, it's good to see Waters out there, because, you know, he made his debut against BC and he scored his first varsity points against Harvard. And he played 5 minutes versus Siena. So they're moving him slowly but surely into the starting lineup. And the band is getting fired up here at the Hart Center. He's challenging the little kids. It's a big guy. And they're giving it back to him. Yeah, give it to him. Yeah.
This looks like a scene out of the WWF over there.
Either that or one of those monsters from the Japanese movies.
Right. Well.
Haystack Calhoun's visiting the Hart Center. He's taking on the kids. Don't mess with those kids. Those kids got some of the musical instruments in their hands. Gonna play a tune on that guy.
Leads down to 11, 40 seconds to play. Waters looking for his first two.
Oh, look at this. Look at this. They're pushing around. And look who stepped in. Look who stepped in.
Paulson.
Justin Johnson out of nowhere set a pick, and it's a dead ball. You got to watch these small little subtle pushing that goes along down there. He's talking to, he's down there talking to Tom Presley, and all of a sudden he's walking away. Then all of a sudden Justin comes over and gives a little pick with the shoulder. I don't think they like each other.
I don't think so either. Waters, a chance to get on the board before we wrap it up. And Malik does it.
Well, that's how West Point plays the game, and that's Babe Kwasniak. Is that his real name? first name Babe?
Babe, I think so. Yeah. Sounds like a movie star, Babe Wozniak. With the look in the name, it's like he's out of the movie Hoosiers. Easy two inside, they blow it.
Yeah, but we saw Driscoll over there. Driscoll's been doing hammer time on the Cadets.
Ian Dombrowski gets two.
Dombrowski, the junior guard, Chaplin, Connecticut.
Johnson pops in a late two, 10.2 remaining, 79-66. Waters pulls up foul line, yes! And the little back step.
Gotta like that one. Let him go, don't stop the clock.
And that's gonna do it, 81-66, the final. The men make it a sweep for the purple at the Hart Center this afternoon. The women winning earlier, 83-29. And Holy Cross can thank guys like Brian Lockhart and Chris Rojic and Ted Bettencourt. They set the table, getting the early lead for Holy Cross. The reserves finishing it off as the Crusaders get only their fifth win of the season and move to 5-10 on the year, now 2-2 in Patriot League play. We'll be back to wrap it up right after this on WGMC TV3.
Every night we report on the news that affects you.
Newswatch 3, Worcester County's only local news.
News about your community without the sensationalism.
Newswatch 3 live at 6:30 and now live at 10.
Our 10 o'clock news is up to date, late breaking information.
We'll have the stories that will be in the paper the next day.
The award-winning Newswatch 3, 6:30 and 10, live on WGMC TV3.
When I was young, I discovered music and practiced to become a musician. Later, I joined the Navy and became an officer and learned about discipline and teamwork and doing your best. Then playing pro ball, the dream of a lifetime. These are the things I love. These are my choices. But none of them would have come true if I hadn't made an important decision a long time ago. I don't do drugs. That's what's worked for me. Think about it.
History, pride, and tradition. The Patriot League represents the best in athletics and education.
Yep.
A combined history of 1,200 years, thousands of successful alumni, and countless achievements all derived from four simple words. Commitment. Celebrated institutions whose athletes are academically representative of the entire student body. Athletics. Ranked fourth among Division I conferences in number of sports offered and second in the number offered to women. Six league champions receive automatic bids into NCAA postseason competition. Academics. The Patriot League has produced over 3,000 honor roll student athletes with a 3.2 grade point average and a varsity letter, including 48 academic All-Americans. And excellence. In 5 years, 46 teams and 30 student athletes have participated in NCAA championship competition, and the conference has ranked number one in the reporting of NCAA graduation rates. This is the Patriot League. A commitment to athletic and academic excellence.
The doubleheader action has come to an end at the Hart Center today. Holy Cross winning the first game and then winning 81-66 here in the second one this afternoon. Great showing by the men. 15 points apiece for Teddy Bettencourt and Brian Lockhart, and then Walter Brown and Chris Rojic with 12 apiece. So a lot of balanced scoring from the Holy Cross starters.
But most importantly, the big people came through today, and I'd like to see a strong showing down low. And they did what they had to do, and that's what they've done. And that's what they needed, a strong performance, especially as a Patriot League game. And they didn't fare so well last time out against Navy, but they were able to make up for it this afternoon.
And how about one of the reserves, one of the big guys, Keith Driscoll? He had a great stretch late in the second half, had like four or five blocks, and this was one of them. Just an emotional play.
Well, that's true, too, because last year, about the end of the season, he missed about 11 games. Preseason, he missed about five games with a broken left hand, but he definitely makes up for it this afternoon, and that's only one of the few that he let go today. And he did a good job.
81-66, the final. Holy Cross winning it to move the record to 2-2 in league play, 5-10 overall. And that follows a win earlier by the women, 83-29 over Army, as the Cross sweeps the Cadets, the Black Knights, the USMA, call them what you want, right out of town. Holy Cross, a double winner this afternoon. So we make it through another doubleheader, Ernie Floyd, and thanks to the production crew today. It's a lot of tough work to carry the cameras and push the buttons for two games, not to mention Channel 3 had a high school game last night. But always a lot of fun. Don't forget, we'll have another one for you Wednesday night, Holy Cross and Fordham. Once again, the final, the Satyrs take it 81-66 from the Hart Center. Again, a 15-point win for Holy Cross, getting their fifth win of the season as Army goes down this afternoon. Don't forget to join Channel 3 on Wednesday. The men, can they keep it going? They play Cornell Monday night. They hope to win that one and come back at it Wednesday night against the Atlantic 10's Fordham Rams. And it's all right here live at 7 o'clock. Make that a 7 o'clock start on Channel 3. For my broadcast partner, Ernie Floyd, and for our statistics man today, Phil Robo, this is John Holt signing off. Have a great weekend, everybody.